Welcome to this webinar. My name is Tobias Hempel. I'm the responsible for plant modernizations at the headquarters here in Eppingen. And today, we would like to introduce you to our brand new EVOsteam, a steam preheating system. I also have a technical counterpart with me.
My name is Johannes Benz. I'm part of the R&D team for the EVOsteam. I will show you today the technical details of the machine.
In the following minute, we will show a short video to give you an overview of the EVOsteam setup. I hope you enjoyed the short introduction video from our brand new EVOsteam. As most of you in the industry already know, the main purpose for using a steam preheater is to gain capacity by increasing the mat temperature before entering the press. However, up to now, there have been undesirable process influences such as condensation spots or stripes when using steam preheaters. We analyzed the market, talked to customers, and redeveloped the product. The results you will see within the next minutes. Johannes, what tasks and challenges did we encounter during the product development?
Our main goal was process safety. We want to increase the plant capacity without any negative impact on the board quality. Our second goal was creating a totally integrated operator principle. Additionally, the machine should be easy to maintain. Also, a precise steam distribution was an important goal. It is necessary to get the steam where it's needed. And of course, the capacity increase has to be done in an energy-efficient manner to save resources and energy costs.
Johannes, typically, like most of our viewers already know, the EVOsteam is installed instead of the current transfer belt. How do we ensure the quick installation and startup and optimization of the system?
We deliver the machine in four major sections, which are easy to handle and quickly assembled. All sensors and actors are pre-wired on a local junction box, and only the field cabling to the customer's existing switchboards are necessary. That all saves time during commissioning.
Can you be a bit more precise? What are the four main components in detail?
We have seen them in our short video at the beginning. We have the EVOsteam lower section, which will replace the transfer belt, and the upper section, both containing the steam blades. We have the steam control unit, the belt cleaning with the side channel blowers, and the secondary heating pump for heating the machine.
Johannes, you said earlier that one of the most important requirements in our product development was process reliability, but also performance increase. What features do we have to offer here?
We have installed a thermal oil heated steam blade, which ensures a reliable heat transfer to the slotted blades due to our special fishbone design. A thermal oil heated reheating zone ensures a total steam transfer into the mat. And that all means no condensation on cold surfaces. Here you can see how the thermal oil heating system works in detail. We take the oil from the press's primary circuit return line and guide it to the EVOsteam. By using thermal oil as heating medium, we get a stable temperature control, which is also easy to handle and easy to maintain, as we don't need condensate traps and a condensate return line for the heating.
In comparison, oil to steam preheated steam plating, how does this influence the energy efficiency in terms of cost?
Normally, steam is generated by thermal oil heated steam generators. Using thermal oil directly for heating means one less temperature transfer and therefore less loss of energy.
Okay, that's clear now. And how about performance gain? How do we reach the best possible performance increase, and what are the typical added steam amounts to the product?
Our steam blade is sectioned, as you can see in the picture behind. Thanks to the individual control of the sections, we are able to set an individual amount of steam for the main section and the pairs of edge sections. And of course, between the upper and lower steam blade. And that all means an optimum steam distribution as required from the production process to ensure ideal board properties. To give you some ideas about the steam amounts, for example, at a 20 mm particle board, we will add approximately 80 g per square meter steam, which means a moisture increase of approximately 1%.
Does the use of an EVOsteam have any other impact on the production facility?
It might be necessary to adjust the recipes of gluing and drying, as well as the press curve.
Of course, as a plant manufacturer with overall experience, we are able to support our customers by doing these steps together with us. What does a good performance mean if the uptime is not ensured? What are we doing on this section, Johannes?
This was the reason why we focused on a machine with a good self-housekeeping. The main part of the belt cleaning is a rotating brush, together with an efficient suction, to remove the dust from the belt surface. At each belt, an air knife, powered by a side channel blower, cleans the belt mesh and removes all moisture. Using side channel blowers for belt cleaning instead of compressed air is much more energy efficient.
We have already spoken about performance increase. I think most of our viewers want to see some performance parameters, as this has essential impact on the payback duration. We have prepared a small sketch for you to give you some further input. Please approach us if you want to know any more specific numbers, especially tailored to your plant. Performance increase is basically related to the board type, particle board, MDF or OSB, the density of the product and the raw board thickness. Of course, there are also other parameters which have impacts on the performance. But as we have only a limited period of time for today, let's keep it simple. Just to give you some examples. For a particle board with a thickness of 20 mm, moving upwards on the y-axis, this will result in a capacity increase of approximately 23%. The curve seen here reflects a standard density.
But of course, these are only some general numbers. If you want to know specific numbers, you can approach Tobias or other colleagues from the sales department.
One more thing, or last but not least. The last key figure what you mentioned was the totally integrated operator principle. What are the benefits for our customers choosing Dieffenbacher as a partner?
The customer gets a machine grinded out of one piece of single wood. If Dieffenbacher installs a machine into an existing Dieffenbacher facility, the customer gets the full integration into the existing operator concept, a smooth machine and human interface. But of course, we will install our machine in any other manufacturer's plant.
Does that mean the input operator parameters of the EVOsteam are added to the existing recipe management or to the automatic product change?
Exactly. And this does mean human errors when changing over to another product can be avoided. And new free resources will be available for other tasks like monitoring the production process somewhere else. And as this is your special experience, Tobias, what other benefits related to electrical integration do we have?
The EVOsteam will be fully integrated into the existing drive concept. This ensures always synchronized drive speed and monitoring to other drives. Mat cracks and any kind of other deflections can be avoided. Also, the drive safety standards will be kept. Unfortunately, we are already at the end of our webinar. I hope you enjoyed the time. Thank you for being with us and see you next time.
Goodbye.